This is a brief video for IAM 200. My name is David Hensley and I'll be your instructor this semester. When you first access our course within Blackboard, you will come to the announcements page. Each week I will post an announcement on which assignments you should be completing. Next under introduction, we have start here. You want to review each step before beginning your assignments. Next you have instructor information. Please feel free to contact me at any time. There's my email address, also telephone number. My preferred method of communication would be email, but feel free to call me if you want to. And you can also set up an appointment. I do have office hours this semester. Next, under introduction, we have syllabus schedule. As you can see, the course syllabus is listed there, and also the assignment schedule, which details all the assignments throughout the semester. Under course content, we have learning modules. There will be a module for each week. Currently, you will only see module 1. Go ahead and click on the link. As you can see, there's different categories here. You have the learning objectives, the assignments, PowerPoint presentation, audio mini lecture, tutorial videos, student data files, discussion board, submit assignments, and test quizzes. You will also find these links on the left-hand side of Blackboard. So as for this week, for the first one, I click on assignments. It's going to detail what you should be working on for week 1. Next, we have the discussion board. Each week, you will have to post to the discussion board except for week 14. The post will consist of initial post and at least a reply to 2 other students. Next, under course content, we have submit assignments. Each week, you will see a chapter folder to submit your assignments to. Go ahead and click on the link. You normally will see a spreadsheet activity and database activity upload link for you to submit your assignments for each week. Next, we have tests and quizzes. Initially, you only see the syllabus quiz. You will need to complete this one after reviewing the syllabus information before you would actually see the chapter 1 quiz. The next is tutorial videos. As you can see, there will be a folder listed for the current chapter. Go ahead and click on the chapter 1 link. You will currently see several videos to assist you with Microsoft Access and Excel. Next, under resources, we have student data files. And I will be posting student data files each week, such as chapter 1s this week. Next week will be chapter 2, so it will be one at a time. You will need to download these files. You can download them from the publisher, but I would prefer you to download them from Blackboard. I know that I kind of removed any errors I've seen throughout the years of working with this textbook, so I think your safe bet would be to download from Blackboard. Student resources, just all the different student resources that are available to you at the college. So please feel free to use any one of them that you need. Okay, next we have my grades. I'm unable to click on my grades since I'm the instructor. I'll just get an error message. When you click on my grades, you're going to see all the different assignments listed, the point value, the due dates, so on and so forth. Okay, so there really should never be a mystery of how you're doing within my class. You would see 3 columns at the very end. The first column is going to be your average total, which would be kind of like your running total. So if you complete 5 assignments, you get 100 on them, you're going to have 100% there and, you know, looking like you're going to be getting an A. But keep in mind, that does not include assignments that have not been posted or have not been graded. So you can't just stop halfway through the course and say, I got 100%, I get an A. You have to finish throughout. So to help, I add another column that says final grade, or final average, I mean, which this gives you a running total, and as you complete the assignments, it continues to increase. So you complete the first 3 of them, you might be up to 7%. Complete a couple more, you might be up to 15%, so on and so forth. So if you're ever wondering kind of what your final grade is towards the very end, look at that final average column. And that's the one you want to really pay attention to, because that includes all assignments, graded or not graded. And then, of course, the very last one will be final grade. If you finish early, I normally will post your final grade early for you so you know exactly how you finished the course. Last, you have tools. Most students will utilize some of these tools within IAM 200. The biggest one would be probably send email, where you can send an email to me, or you can simply just open up your Outlook and type in my email address. Either way, it doesn't matter. I'll respond. I would prefer you to send from your Sensei State account, but I guarantee you if you send from a Gmail or Hotmail or Yahoo, I'm still going to reply to you. I just might not know who it is, but I'll at least reply though. So, Well, I hope you enjoy the semester, and please reach out to me if you have any questions. Have a great day.